Happy morning to all dear students. This is Bhavna Ajwani, your English teacher. Now, students, right from the from this month, we have done a lot of English grammar topics. We have done the revision of it in the video. We have also seen the YLE, which was taken in the month of April, and even we are continuing till now, right? So we have done a lot. And now, students, it's time for us to reflect whether we have understood the concepts or we haven't understood the concepts. Right, students? So today's video is going to be purely upon the revision of units 1 to unit number 6 of the YLE. So we are going to solve the exercise, some questions which will help you to brush up what you have learned in those in the previous 6 lessons of your YLE textbook. Yes, so welcome to all for your English period students. So let us begin. But before that, it is mandatory for you all to open your YLE textbook, take a pencil and an eraser so that you all are at the same page, at the same line where am I or what we what am I saying or doing in the video. So let us begin and open your textbooks to page number 46. Yes. Yes, so we are going to focus on units 1 to 6 revision. Now, before I proceed with the topics and with the revision today, students, I had given you all one homework, right? This unit only, that is your question number 2. Yes. Now, you need to read the text and think of the word which fits best in each gap. It was quite an easy homework, students. You were being given the text and then you had to fill the text with the correct option or the correct word to fill in the blank, right? So I hope that we you all have done the homework, and it's time for you students right now to cross-check and verify your answers. Yes, you all can pause and you all can make a note of the answers if you all have missed out something or if something is incorrect. Now we shall move to our question number 1. Okay, together with a partner, read these sentences and discuss which are true for you, giving more details. Try to use as much of the vocabulary and language as you can from the units you have just studied. So this is going to be a personal response, students. It's, now I am going to discuss it with you all. Yes, but you, for some of the sentences, it may be true for you and some may be false for you. Okay, so it is going to be all personal responses for this question. So I am going to do it with you all. Yes, so let us begin the first each sentence. I always get out of the bed early in the morning. Get out means I get up early. I wake up early in the morning. So for me, yes, it is true. I wake up early in the morning because I complete off my work. I feel very energetic. I have to do my lectures, or I have to study for my lectures, or I have to study for several subjects. Yes, so it is true for me. So for what? It is what for your students? You have to write your own answer. If it is false, you will write false and you will give an explanation for it, that why it is false. Next, if I had some money, the first thing I would buy is a fast car. So for me, it is false, students. My plan is different if I would have a lot of money. Yes, so for y'all, whatever is your answer, whether it is true, whether it is false, you're going to write that there over there with your pencil. Next, I am worse at English than I am at maths. This is also very false. Okay, this is false for me. For me, maths is worse than English. For y'all, what it is, it's up to you. Next, I'm always getting into trouble for forgetting things. Yes. Many a times it happens, right? You have a habit of forgetting things and you end up getting into trouble somewhere. So for me, this is also false. I most probably do not forget. I keep it into my mind. Next, I'm not afraid of anything. This is false. I am afraid for several things, right? Like I am afraid from reptiles. Yes. Next, I think I'm broad-minded. Broad means open-minded. Yes. And for me, this is true. And for you all, what it is, you'll have to write whether true or false. I must try to work harder. Yes, this is true for me. I shall make it a point that I work harder in order to achieve success or in order to be a better person. Next, I like to follow fashion. Yes, this is true for me, for you all, whatever it is, you are going to write. Books interest me more than computer games. Yes, true. And beach holidays are not for me. Not for me means you all do not enjoy the beach holidays. The meaning of that is that. Beach holidays like Goa and so on, Alibag and so on. So it is true again for me because I do not like to go for beaches on holidays. Yeah. So that's the first part, students. Now we'll move to the third part. We need to complete the following sentences using the appropriate verb. Now, these are the phrasal verbs. Okay, students, phrasal verbs question. You have also been given the option that you need to use the phrasal verb up, which is there in your sentence. And you need to complete each blank by filling the appropriate verb in those blanks. Yes. So let us do it together. If Elizabeth had been able to dash up just a little more money, she would have bought a fast computer. Yes. So if Elizabeth had been able to save up, so it is S-A-V-E, save up. If she could have saved up some money, she could have bought a faster car. Yes. So you need to complete these blanks. These are all like from A to E. These are the blanks by with the phrasal verb that is up. In each blank, you will see up is there. Now you need to enter the verb over there. Yes, right? Let us do the second one. Every time I go shopping for clothes, I find that prices have dashed up yet again. Prices have risen up or have gone up. Both are correct, students. Gone or risen, R-I-S-E-N. Risen also means going up. Yes, have you make a note of the answers as I'm discussing with you all. Third one, come just as you are. There's really no need to dash up. So what the sentence is telling, come however you are. There's nothing for you to dash up. Okay, so there's nothing for you to dress up. So the answer is dress, D-R-E-S-S. Next one. Sarah was walking so fast that I couldn't dash up with her. She was walking so fast that I couldn't keep up with her. Right? We have done this phrasal verb in the previous, in the last unit also. So keep or catch up with her. Both are correct, students. Keep or catch. Fifth one. When you manage to find his address, dash me up and let me know what it is. When you find the address, call me up or phone me up. Both are correct. Call or phone. Both will be correct, students. Now, we move to the next part of the question, students. Now, these are also the phrasal verbs, but these phrasal verbs are with out. First one we did with up. Now we are doing it with out. Yes? Tourist guides often carry umbrellas so that they dash out in a crowd. You know who are tourist guides, students? Now, suppose if you all go at a tourist place, suppose you go to Ajanta Ellora Caves, there you have these people who guide you, who give you the additional and in-deep information about the place, about the caves or anything, wherever you are going and hiring a travel guide. Yes, or tourist guides. Tourist guides often carry umbrellas so that they can, sorry, so that they stand out in a crowd, so that they are able to stand in a crowd. Next one, Sheila decided to dash out of the hotel a bit early so she wouldn't miss her plane. So Sheila decided to check in or check out, students. Check in is wherein you enter into the hotel, into the hotel, and check out is when you're leaving the hotel. So it is check out because she had decided to leave early so that she wouldn't miss her plane. Next, I don't know how you can dash out looking like that, Sue's mother said. Yes, I don't know how you can go out looking like that. Yeah. Next, I'm not sure I can dash out how to play this computer game. I'm not sure I can manage out how to play this computer game. Now, let us move to the next part. These are all your exercises on the phrasal verbs. Okay. Now, look at these mixed examples and replace the verb or phrase in italics with a phrasal verb or a common noun. Now, what we have to do is in each sentence, students, you will see that there are some words or phrases or some sentence, some words which are in italics. So what you have to do is you need to replace those italic words by putting the appropriate phrasal verb over there. Now, these phrasal verbs could be anything which you have studied till now, but it should match over there, or it could be from the options or the questions which we have done right now, but it is completely depending upon the sentence. Okay, first, if you want to look good in that outfit means dress, you will have to reduce the amount of the chocolate you eat. Yes, so reduce is something which is written in italic. So what can be the phrasal verb, students? Think. If you want to look good in that outfit, you will have to cut down. Right? Cut down means to reduce. Yes. Cut down. CUT. Cut down the amount of chocolate you eat. Next, we spend some time in Singapore on our way to Sydney. Yes. We spent some time. Spent some time. So how will you replace it with the phrasal verb? Which phrasal verb you will choose or you will select? The stopped over. Yes, that's the correct one which is suitable. We stopped over in Singapore on our way to Sydney. What is Sydney, students? Sydney is the capital of Australia. Okay. Next, I really hate shops that make you feel guilty when you return clothes that shrink in the wash or fall to pieces. Shrink means to reduce in the size. Okay, reducing. I really hate shops that make you feel guilty when you return. So now you need to replace that word return with the phrasal verb. Yes, when you take back. Take back means you're returning, you're taking it back to that person or to that shop. So take back. TAKE and back. BACK. Yes. Next, we decided to start the journey to the castle at midnight in the hope of seeing the ghost. We decided to start the journey. So this start the journey, you need to replace with a phrasal verb. Yes, so we decided to set off the journey. Set off means to begin, to start. Okay, SET, set, and OFF, off. Next, the police officer told them not to go near the edge of the cliff. Near the edge means ending, okay, on the border. So the police officer told them not to go, not to go. You need to replace that with phrasal. What happens many a times, your teachers and your parents also say, "Na, I warn you that you do not if you do not complete your work, you will not be allowed to play." So the police officer warned them. Oh, sorry. I'm really sorry. So the police officer told them to keep away. To keep away means to stay away, not to be close to someone. To stay away. So the answer is to keep away or to stay away. Next, last one. My friend had to spend about 2 hours waiting in the plane for it to leave. So this leave, yes, it is take off. Okay. Take off means to begin, to start something, to leave. We say that the plane is about to take off. The plane is about to leave. Yes. I hope that you all have done till here, students. Now turn your textbooks to page number 47. We need to do the question number 4. Quite an easy one, students. It's about the revision of the present and past tenses. Right? So you need to read this text, and we have been given the verbs in the bracket, students. We need to put the appropriate form of the verb, whether the past or whether the present tense only, depending upon the sentences. Yes? So let us begin and do it together. The statistics on the safety of flying dash immensely. Immensely means very deeply, to a great extent. So the verb is be. So what will be there, students? The statistics on the safety of flying are immensely comforting. Comforting means very comfortable. It seems, again we are using simple present. It seems that the chances of being involved in an accident are 1,000,000 to 1. Yes, A-R-E. Third one is again R, A-R-E. A million to one. The equivalent of flying safety every day for 95 years. Try telling to that white-faced, petrified, aerophobic who again the fourth one blank, look into your books, C is there, who seems, again we have to use the present, who seems very frown on a stewardess face as a portent of disaster. Disaster for some years now. Psychologist Henry Jones. Yes. Dry is the verb. So how are you going to change? Psychologist Henry Jones has tried, or only tried. Both can be correct. Okay. T-R-I-E-D. Has tried or tried to tell them, and he has done. Okay, so the verb is do. We are putting it in the correct form. Has done a lot more besides. He has developed. Yes, he has developed both a theory and practice for treating air travel anxiety. Anxiety means constant worrying about something. Okay. Apparently, it is a widespread phobia. Phobia means some kind of thing, mentality, which is already there into your mind. And phobia means a fear of something. Okay, a fear which is already there. Like you will come across that many people have the phobia of traveling in the aeroplane because they are, you know, they have a phobia of height. Phobia means they have a, what we can say, they have a fear of something. Okay, so they here it is describing about the phobia of flying or sitting or traveling in an aeroplane. One American survey has put it as the fourth most common fear. Fear means frightening, dar lagna. Okay, preceded only by snakes. Preceded means just behind the snakes, heights and storms. Jones has had nearly 500 clients means customers, okay, during the last decade means 10 years, okay, before they came to him. Some of his clients had never flown means flied, okay, had never flown, flown, had never flown. Others had, so here we are using the past tense, okay, so others had just one bad experience after years of flying. One man took, so we are using the past of take, okay, one man took over 200 flights a year for 5 years and had never worried, worried, had never worried up till now. Then one day on a flight to Chicago, the pilot announced, that they were going to turn back because of an engine fault. The man then had. Can we use just directly have as a present? No, that will not form the grammatically correct structure of the sentence. So the man had a panic attack and tried to get off the plane in mid-air. After Jones' course, the man overcame. To overcome means to come out of something. So over here, after the course of the Jones, the man overcame his fears. Yes, and managed to fly again. Managed. M-A-N-A-G-E-D. Yes. I hope that you all have done the writing till here. Yes, students. Now, question number 5 is going to be your homework. I hope that you all know what are we going to do or what we have to do over here. Okay, so you have been given one sentence is your question. Then you have the hint word, which is highlighted and bold in capital. And there is second sentence given to you. And what you have to do is you need to complete that second sentence by putting not more than 5 words, but if you're adding those 5 words, students, your hint word has to be there in that sentence. And you have to reframe your sentence. But when you're going to reframe your sentence, students, please make sure that the meaning doesn't change. The meaning should remain the same with the question given to you as your first sentence. So I'll just give an answer for the first one. And then your others, the rest, it will be your homework, and you have to do it in your textbook itself with a pencil. Yes. Andrea said she would only go dancing if her husband bought her a new outfit. Yes. So your hint word is given as unless, which you need to use it in your second sentence when you're forming the answer. Andrea said that And sorry, Andrea said she wouldn't go dancing unless her husband bought her a new outfit. So I have added three words, and in those three words, students, I have also added the clue word, that is unless. So in that way, you will be solving all the rest questions, and I shall display and discuss the answers in the next video. Yes, that's it for today, students. And I hope that you all are completing your work onto the time. And many students, I have checked, they have uploaded all their submissions in the PDF format. I don't know why, because we have told you that it should be scanned and uploaded in the JPG format only. And there are some students who have not even uploaded the previous worksheets which I had given in the month of April, right? You all have sent those worksheets as a mail, but it is important for you all to upload it onto the drive because we need to check them. Yes, and many students have, I have checked that they have not even uploaded reader lesson number 3 completed notes. So kindly don't do that, students. Please upload those notes completed and uploaded. And as and when you're completing the notes, na, upload it. Keep on uploading onto the drive. Don't just keep for the end moment that you will upload it at the end. Then it's going to end up taking a lot of data. So please don't do that, students. As and when you finish for any subject, start uploading your notes so that the teachers can do the checking. And most of the students have also not written the vocab help. I had told you all very clearly in the video that you all have to write your vocab help of each lesson of reader into your notes, because those meanings are very important. You should know the meanings. Yes. So I hope that you will do that, students. And yeah, that's it for today. And we meet again in the next period. Till then, continue to be at home and continue to do your studies. Thank you, students.